When I find something I really like to do, I kind of have a tendency to overdo it. And counting's no different. You see, I really like counting, but sometimes I overcount. And sometimes that's exactly the right thing to do. For example, last weekend I had a party, and I invited all my friends. But I told each friend they have to bring one other person. They can bring a friend, they can bring a date, but they have to come as a couple. Now, once the party started, I saw everybody was there, and I was looking around. I was trying to figure out how many couples actually came, because I knew some of my friends, well, they might not come, because the last time I made them do math problems the whole time. But fortunately, I have a lot of really cool friends who like to do math problems, so there were still a lot of people at this party. Now, I was trying to figure out how many couples there were, but the people had already all mixed together, so I couldn't just kind of pair them off, each couple as they came, because they were already mixed up. But I figured, well, I can at least count the number of people who were there, including myself and the person I brought. And I found that there were 56 people who were there. And I'm trying to count the number of couples, and I realize, well, here I've overcounted. I've counted every couple exactly twice. So because I've counted every couple twice here, I can fix my overcounting by simply dividing by 2. If I count every couple twice to get 56, when I divide by 2, I count every couple exactly once, which tells me that there are 28 couples. And I thought, that's perfect. But then I wanted everyone to meet all the other people at the party. And I'd like my friends to meet each other and the people they brought to meet each other. So I came up with this rule. You're not allowed to leave the party until you high-five every other person at the party. It's not enough just to say, hi, I'm Jane, or hi, I'm Richard. You can handshakes. You shake hands with anybody, but to high-five someone, you can't just high-five a random person on the street. So I figured everybody has to high-five with everyone else. Everyone will get to know each other. So, of course, we're going to count the number of high-fives. Now, because this is a little bit more complicated problem than counting the couples, we're going to do this problem two ways. And the first way we're going to do it is, if you think about at a basketball game. A basketball game, when they call the starting lineup, the players run out and they run through the high-five tunnel. High-five, high-five, high-five. Well, that's what we were going to do at the party. So I took the other 55 people. I get to go first because I'm the host. Take the other 55 people, put them in a row, and then I run through. High five, high five, high five. And because there are 55 people in the line, I give 55 high fives. And then I'm finished. I sit down. I've high-fived everybody. And then one person gets out of line. That leaves 54 left. And then she runs through. High five, high five, high five. And so she high fives 54 people running through that line. Then the next person gets out, and there are 53 left for her to high five with. And so on, 52, 51, and we'll keep on going all the way down until there are just 4 people left in the line. One of them gets out and high fives the other 3. And then we'll have 2 high fives, and then just 1 little high five at the end. And here's our total number of high fives. And we've counted every single pair of people. Every single high five is counted in here. So let's see, we could just add this up, or maybe you even know a formula for it. And if you don't know a formula for it, try to figure one out. And you could use algebra, or you could use counting. And we're going to see how to do that. Instead of adding up all these numbers, let's try to think of another way that we could have counted all the high fives. And, well, we'll start with me. You notice that I high-five 55 people when I run through. So, there's the 55 for me. And there's nothing special about me. Now, my mom says I'm special, but she has to. It's right there in the contract, the mom contract. You must think the child is special. But there's nothing special about me. I high-five 55 people, so does everyone else. Everybody high-fives 55 other people. There are 56 people at the party. Each one of them high-fives 55 times, which tells me we've got 56 times 55 high-fives. But wait a second. These two numbers can't possibly be the same. They're both counting the number of high-fives, so they're supposed to be the same. But they're clearly not. There are 55 numbers up here, and every single one of them is less than 56. So this is going to be way bigger than this. So this, something went wrong here. So step back and think about this for a minute, and I think about my high fives, and then the person I brought Vanessa, and we think about her high fives. Then think about when we high-five each other. Well, I count it once here for me, and then I count it once for her. So this 55 times 56 counts every single high-five 2 times. But we only want to count each high-five once, so we have to divide by 2. And since 55 times 56 overcounts, counts every high-five twice, when we divide by 2, we count every high-five once. And this will give us the total number of high-fives. And to figure this out, well, 2 goes into 56 28 times, multiply that by 55, and we get 1,540. And of course, since these expressions, they both count the number of high-fives, these two expressions have to be equal. So maybe you can use this observation to figure out what a formula is for adding the numbers 1, 2, 3, all the way up to some other number. Now this problem points out a couple very important counting principles. First of all is our strategy here in our second solution. We overcounted by counting everything the same number of times, counted everything twice. And then to fix that and get the right count, we divided by how many times we counted each high five. We divided by 2. And that allows us to count each high five exactly once. And second, this happens a lot in counting problems. You're trying to count something and you come up with 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 and so on up to some number of whatever you're trying to count. And whenever you see this in a counting problem, whenever you come up with this 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, there's almost always another faster way to do the problem. And it almost always will look a lot like this.